On this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball, Presbyterian College treats its great home alumni crowd to a key Big South Conference win over Longwood. We'll talk about the games from last week, break down all the highlights, and check out the plays of the week before looking ahead to a trip to Charleston Southern. All that and more on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Founders Federal Credit Union. Relax, you're with Founders. By Self Regional Healthcare, we bring advanced care closer. By Fats Cafe of Clinton, making your tailgate deliciously easy. And by Coca-Cola, the official soft drink of Presbyterian College.
Welcome to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. I'm Ryan Riau with head coach Gregg Nibert. Coach, great win to talk about over Longwood. Let's just jump right in. You guys needed it, and you guys got it in front of a great home crowd.
Well, it was needed, and it was the second time around in the league, and trying to do everything just a little bit better. But Ryan just couldn't be prouder of our basketball team. The last time we tasted victory was December 17th on a Saturday, and for the guys to come to practice every day and just be there for each other. We talk about three things all the time: pulling for each other and being a team. Mm-hmm. Number one, giving maximum effort on defense every possession, and really trying to get better with your offensive execution. And for the guys to come to practice every day and do their due diligence and stick together. I wrote a word up on the board after the game and talked about it, and it's kind of a lost word, I think, is loyalty.
Sure.
And we could have been splintered. We could have been everybody going their separate ways and blaming this and blaming that. Our coaches did a tremendous job. We stuck together. Our players did a tremendous job sticking together. And like I said, couldn't have been prouder of a basketball team to, keep persevering and sticking together. And what a great win on a great alumni night for everyone.
Absolutely. And I've seen the Adidas shirt, the PC loyalty. That's something you stress. And throughout this kind of run, we've talked about, you doing things well here and there. You're able to really put it all together in that win over Longwood.
Well, we did. And we took care of the ball, which we haven't been doing, and had a great job taking care of the basketball. We got the ball down inside. Reggie Dillard was tremendous, showing much the best leadership he's shown at that position, not just scoring-wise, but getting assist offense. Mm-hmm. Darius Moore did a great job along with Ed. JV, everybody came off the bench, did a tremendous job. Will Adams and Jaron and everybody played a big role, Ruben and TT. So it was a great team win, and like I said, couldn't have been prouder of them.
Absolutely. And now let's take a look at some of those highlights from the win over Longwood.
Game highlights are brought to you by
first play here, offensively trying to get the ball down on the block to Ed, run a little on-ball screen there, driving it off. Good throw back there. Good job of going down there inside, and going down inside to Austin, who had another really fine game, and really proud of Austin. Again, we're in the zone. We have a turnover in the zone, and JV taking that ball all the way to the basket. And what a great finish. We had some really great fast break. Baseline out of bounds here. Again, we get a seal there, and a great pass in there from Reggie to JV. Again, off the miss, Reggie pushing it. Great pass inside, and great dunk there, going to the rim by Ed. Ed just really having a great senior year.
He really has 21 points in that game.
Yeah, tremendous. They play a little zone. They go to zone. We run a little out-of-bounds play. Again, probably don't run it exactly like, but we still get what we want, a little lob there play, and great screen by Ruben, another great pass by Reggie. Again, pushing the ball, 6'3 point guard, which great pass right over there, and great shot by JV. Great job by JV pointing Reggie out as well. Again, run a little play here for Reggie to drive the basketball. He's taking the guy all the way down to the lane. You see the guy just bouncing off of him, and that's what a 6'3 point guard can do, and getting in that lane. And that's what Reggie needs to do. Instead of shooting a three, driving that ball. Again, we curl play, a design curl play right in there for Ed. Could have really went the other way, but great job there by JV screening. Again, Darius is at the point guard now, gets this loose ball. Great pass there to Reggie. And great finish there by Reggie.
He had a huge second half.
Yeah, he did. He sure did. Again, we're setting a little screen there, trying to go down inside the head. Stagger away for JV, don't have anything. Go into our shot clock play, which is an on-ball screen for Reggie, and taking it all the way in there. What a great finish. What a great finish. Again, like I said, he played one of his best games. Again, JV bringing it up, and good job by JV taking it to that rub spot and going right down there inside to Ed, and Ed making a really nice move with his left hand. Another on-ball screen, throwback. Great extra pass there by JV. Another one, and Austin Anderson, or Austin Venable, just came up with an unbelievable, mm-hmm. Shot there. Again, they're pressing. Good hustle there by Darius.
Yeah, great work to get that ball back.
Yeah. It's a great feeling here when the team's, trying to foul you and didn't turn the ball over. Another on-ball screen here. Good penetrate, good patience here. And then Reggie right here at the end. Taking it, and getting all the way down there and laying it in. He can do more of that. What a great win.
Coach, great to get a win, and especially great with all the PC basketball history to kind of have it on alumni night, a performance like that.
Well, it was. We had Shannon Reed in our Walter Johnson Scotsman Club. She mm-hmm. did a great job along with Lenny Patterson and everybody involved there. Had a great turnout there at the Harper Center before mm-hmm. the game, and always have our 1960s group that they come back sure. strong, and Bruce Thompson and Marjorie, and what a great turnout. And we looked at the 96-97 team that had a great career there and a championship, and they came back and had those guys over at the house after the game. So what a great weekend it was, and what a great group of alumni who really, truly, love Presbyterian College, mm-hmm. love the basketball program, but ultimately just love PC and them coming back every year. So they even came to shoot around that morning, so which was neat.
Maybe you have them back every week.
Yeah, no question.
The way that went. Ed Drew, 21 points, 9 rebounds. He has more double-digit games this year than he had, in his previous 3 years. What has he been able to do that's really allowed him to dominate in conference play for you guys?
Well, I think one thing Ed does is Ed has a tremendous confidence in himself, which is great. You got to have that. He really works on his game every year, and he can really get that ball down on the block and don't really realize how long Ed's arms are. Right. But when he gets that ball down there on that left block and kind of takes it to the middle and then brings it back with his left hand, he's really shooting a layup. And I think it surprises a lot of people on how long and he is and can score down there on the block.
Mm-hmm. What can a win, especially against a team you've seen before, kind of get that revenge game, even up the season series, what can that do for you guys?
Well, what it did is it gave us a lot of confidence. And what it also proved, and I couldn't have been prouder of the guys, mm-hmm. like I've already mentioned, and beat a dead horse, is not many people can stay together, mm-hmm. After you've lost 10 games in a row. And couldn't have been prouder of their work ethic, their attitude. And that's what it's all about, and pulling for each other. So, we still got to take good care sure. of the basketball. But, what you want to do is be playing your best basketball at the end of the year. And mm-hmm. That win, the second time around, we obviously played better at home than we did up at Longwood. Mm-hmm. At Longwood, we really couldn't stop them, mm-hmm. But was really proud. We held them to 62 points. We did some really nice things in the zone, mm-hmm. and think that this zone will just do nothing but get better and better. And our big Achilles heel so far has been turnovers
right.
And we did a good job taking care of the ball, and that's going to be something big for the rest of the year.
Absolutely. All right, great to see. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, we're going to talk about PC's game against Liberty, as well as check out our offensive, defensive, and hustle plays of the week. That's when we return on this edition of Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
We're fighting cancer with caring, with technology, with knowledge. And now, with the Hollings Clinical Trial Network at the Medical University of South Carolina. Together, we're bringing more advanced cancer care close to home. Self-Regional Healthcare Cancer Center. We bring advanced care closer. We'll be right back.
What are you doing?
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Bojangles, it's Bo Time. And by Jeff Smith Allstate Insurance of Clinton. You're in good hands with Jeff Smith and Allstate.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. All right, Coach, you get the win against Longwood, and then you have to go to really the cream of the crop right now, top of the standings in the Big South Liberty.
Well, we did, and we're really coming off a win, and had to practice on Sunday a little bit and did some things with our defense, and then had a great practice on Monday and got on the bus for that about five-hour drive and getting in there about 9 or 9:30 and had a great shoot-around and great scouting report, and the guys were really – really ready to go, so we knew we had to play our best. They put it on us pretty good, shooting a three at our place, we felt like we were really ready to go in the beginning of the game.
It came out like gangbusters, and they were able to catch up and get that.
Well, they did, and unfortunately, is what got us again was our turnovers. We really were playing really good defense. It was 11-3 with 11 minutes to go in the first half, and even though we had five turnovers, we could have been ahead, 17-3 or 18-3, and the turnover, just careless turnovers, which is disappointing on the road. You can't fumble the football or throw interceptions, but like I said, we had 11-3 lead with 11 minutes to go, and we had 11 turnovers, a turnover a minute in the rest of the half, and only go we end up going down 30-21, but our defense was tremendous, but you just can't turn the ball over against a very good team, and that's what we did.
Tough to do against anybody, especially at the top of the team at the top of the standings. All right, now we're going to take a look at the highlights from Presbyterian College's game at Liberty.
Game highlights are brought to you by Matt Davis State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there.
Well, we couldn't have had any better start. I was really proud of our defense. We did some things with our zone, moving the ball from side to side, a little stagger away, curled in the screen, kind of losing the ball there a little bit. Go into a little bit of a shot clock play or set play. Great screen there by Darius. Great down screen. Good job on ball, throwing the ball. Darius having to launch one up there and it going in, which was, he's really shooting the ball really well. Again, Will Adams out there, getting pretty good pressure, high hands with the ball, good closeout. Great contest there by Ruben. Great block out there by Austin. Again, pushing the ball. Ruben going to the rim, feeding it right down there inside. And Ruben did a great job of just backing the guy down there and shooting over him. You can see we got a 7-3 lead. They only got 3 points in 7.5 minutes, so our defense was tremendous. Again, we'd like to probably go down there and trap that, and they throw the ball away. Again, good pickup here by Darius. Good pressure there by Ed. Good job by Reggie. Good job going underneath that screen there. Great contest by Ed Drew. We talked about contesting every three because they're such a great three-point shooting team. Still, we still got a lead 9-3 with 11 something to go. Like to get that ball down inside there to Ed. Good ball movement, good on-ball screen by Ed. Good drive by Reggie, good feed to post there. They go and fire on him with this double team and a trap. Like to move the ball, great crossover right there. And again, we're ahead 11-3 in the first 10 minutes. Run a little play right here. Going down inside the head, and what a great execution. Beautiful pass by Reggie, but great screen there by Jaron. Again, pushing the ball by Darius, getting to the rub spot, looking inside, swinging the ball. Curl that screen. Nice pass. Like to get Austin up here a little quicker to move the ball. He finally gets out. There's Ed setting an on-ball screen, and great job there by a great screen. Mm-hmm. And Will Adams coming off that screen and shooting that 15-footer. Again, pushing the basketball, making a three there by Reggie.
Coach, you saw a little bit of it there, and we talked about it, touched on him in the first game. Reggie Dillard, four straight games in double digits for him.
Yeah, he's really doing a nice job. We've moved into that point guard position, and he's really taking hold of it, giving us good leadership. And 6'3", 220-pound point guard, which doing a tremendous job. But he just gives you, you know, some posting up, gives you some driving ability. And like I said, he's really, you know, leading us. So he's doing a really good job, and I know that's going to continue.
What kind of leadership have you seen from the, you know, Will and Reggie and Ed, the guys who, you know, have been here for a while, and you have a young group, and you know the season hasn't gone the way you wanted it. What kind of leadership have you seen from them?
Well, it's more of a lead by example. Mm-hmm. You know, they're not the kind of guys that are going to tell anybody what to do, but they come out every day and they work hard and mm-hmm. they have a great attitude. It's yes sir, no sir, and that helps everybody. Mm-hmm. And for two seniors to do that, and even, you know, Will started at times, and now he's coming off the bench, mm-hmm. and you wouldn't be able to tell any difference in his attitude, and that's what it's all about, and that's what you know these guys are doing and providing, and hadn't been the greatest thing, but for them to, like I said, come with a great attitude and great work ethic is tremendous for those younger players.
And that's not something you can really teach, especially with the loyalty piece and working together. It's great to see, great to hear about. All right, we're going to take a look at our offensive play of the week. First brought to you by Steve Crow of Foothills Motorsports.
Well, we had some good offensive plays. They're in zone now, which are trying to play a little 2-3 zone. Good on-ball screen. Don't use it. Get the ball back to Darius up at the top. Looking to run a little set play against the zone. Getting good screen there by Ruben. Driving it off and going all the way to the basket, which is a great job there, and great job by Ed, and great job by Darius.
We've seen it a lot this season, you know, Darius with the high dribble. He can pull from anywhere. Mm-hmm. This time, he takes it inside, gets 2 points in the paint. Now it's time for our defensive play of the week, brought to you by Swain Brown Accounting Services and Upstate Insurance Consultants.
Show a little 2-2-1 press there back to our zone. Try to take some time off the clock. Good hustle there by Will. High hands. We always like to come out with high hands. Get your hands up against on the shooters. Good job there by Ruben getting his hands up. Again, they're working the zone. Good job there by Darius. Great job there by Ed, and great block, and what a great possession that was defensively. Which leads to great offense. Good hustle there by Ed, getting the 2 points.
We love the points off the turnovers, because mm-hmm. not only do you deny them points, you get some on the other end. There it was with the defensive play of the week. Now, let's take a look at the hustle play of the week, brought to you by former PC coach and player, Dan Nunnery.
Now, the hustle play here is, kind of getting after Reggie a little bit. He goes underneath that screen. Good pass there to Ed. Can't seem they're denying, which they do. Great hustle there by JV. Falls down, hurts his ankle, but great job of taking that ball right away from the guy with Austin Venable and getting that 2 points. And JV was okay.
The three great things about that play, the points, the hustle, and then the JV was okay. I want to stress that. All right. Well, now we're going to take our final timeout. When we come back, we're actually going to talk about the health of the Blue Hose with the Palmetto Bone and Joint Injury Report, as well as our Baird Truck and Trailer Sales next week's preview. That's when we return to Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
I'm a random windstorm. Shaky, 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 shaky. Shaky, shaky. And if you got cut rate insurance, you could be picking up this tab yourself. So get Allstate. You could save some cash and be better protected from mayhem like me.
If you're considering joint replacement surgery, ask yourself these questions. Is my orthopedic surgeon experienced in joint replacement? Does he listen to my concerns? Explain all my options? Will he manage my pain? Will he help me regain the active life I want? The orthopedic surgeons of Palmetto Bone and Joint are proud members of Newberry Hospital's award-winning joint replacement team. We're among the best in the state and nation for hip and knee replacement. You have a choice. Palmetto Bone and Joint.
Let's As you set your financial game plan, we'll be with you every play. Relax, you're with Founders.
There once was a family, a lot like this one. And they were traveling far away where there were no Bojangles. The family needed breakfast, but they had gotten a late start. They pulled up to a drive-thru of a strange restaurant, and a loud voice boomed. We stopped serving breakfast at 10 a.m.
Oh, honey.
At Bojangles, we've always served breakfast all day. Come in for a pork chop biscuit today. Bojangles, it's bow time.
This portion of Inside Blue Hose Basketball is brought to you by
Matt Davis State Farm Insurance of Clinton. Like a good neighbor, Matt Davis and State Farm are there. Cooper Motor Company, sales and service of Chrysler, Jeep, Dodge, and Ram trucks since 1938. Chick-fil-A of Lawrence, home of the original chicken sandwich.
Welcome back to Inside Blue Hose Basketball. Coach, let's talk about the health of the Blue Hose with the palmetto bone and joint injury report.
Well, we're getting better. Obviously, Miles McGregor is still doing better with his ankle. We talked about Devon. You know, he's out for the year, but going to get him ready back and hopefully have two great years with him. So we're excited about that. And just got a great report for J.C. Younger that he's going to be hopefully back in a couple weeks.
We have two
good weeks before we go into that tournament. So we're really excited about getting J.C. back. So that's real exciting.
That could be a huge shot in the arm. That's great news. All right, now let's take a look at the preview for this week with Charleston Southern with our Baird truck and trailer sales next week's preview.
Next week's preview is sponsored by Baird Transport for all your logistical and material transport needs.
Coach, on the road again with Charleston Southern this week, a big Saturday matchup.
Well, it is. And they really shot the lights out at home, and they've got a great three-point shooting team, and we're going to be tested again in that zone, so we've got to really do a good job of making sure we get out to these shooters much better than we got to at home, and hopefully we can put some points on the board as well. They ran a little 1-2-2 three-quarter court press and went back to a zone, so we haven't had many teams zone us, so we've got to do a good job taking care of the balls, and again, another game where we had gave up 20 points off our turnovers, so can't have any turnovers in the backcourt, and like I say, got to do a good job attacking their zone.
You talked about your zone defensively and last against Liberty. You know, you guys were able to shoot the ball fairly well, 45%. Just the turnovers, like you said.
And Nelson Jones was over there keeping track of our stats, and he said, "Coach, he said you're either scoring or you're turning it over." Which we've got to do a good job of getting more shots, and we had 20 less shots than Liberty. And what could you have done with 20 more shots and giving them 10 or 15 less shots. So it's a double-edged sword like we've talked about. A young basketball team coming off a big win. We really weren't, it seemed like some guys just a little lackadaisical with their decision-making and with the basketball. And we all got to be strong with that ball. And hopefully we can do a good job, tonight against Charleston Southern.
Absolutely. Coach, I feel like we don't talk about him enough, but J.V. Milner, the season he's having as a freshman, normally when freshmen have big seasons, it's either non-conference and they cool down. He's just been able to hit his numbers pretty consistently.
Well, he has. And the Liberty game was probably his worst game of the year. Yeah. But other than that, he's really done a super job. I couldn't be prouder of JV, coming out of high school, playing for his high school coach and coming into college and really a lot of different things are new and exciting for him. He's really had to respond, really more than your average freshman and really challenged him. And he's gotten tougher. He needs to keep getting tougher mentally. And the tougher he gets mentally, the better player he's going to be. But he's really answered the bell, and I know he's going to have a good game against Charleston Southern coming off that Liberty game.
This week, real quick, was big football signing day. You guys in April, and people don't realize you guys are always recruiting.
Well, we are, and we've got two signing periods, one in November, one in April, and we signed two guys early, and they've had tremendous years, which
we're
really,
awesome.
Really excited about Romeo and Duncan Lysander, so we got two really good players.
Fantastic. Yeah. Great to hear. All right, well, that'll do it for us. For the Coach Gregg Nibert, I'm Ryan Rial. Don't forget you can catch everything Blue Hose online at GoBlueHose.com, and you can watch all the away games on BigSouthSports.com. We appreciate you watching, and we'll see you next week when we return to Inside Blue Hose Basketball.
Inside Blue Hose Basketball was brought to you by
Smith Chevrolet of Lawrence, providing premier new car sales and service in Lawrence for over 60 years. By Palmetto Bone & Joint, the official orthopedic care provider for PC Athletics. And by Carolina Fresh Farms, the official turf grass of Presbyterian College.